स्किल तुम्हारे वो भी ख़राब हैं।
आज के लिए फुल मसाला।
A.K. Antony. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Professor V.N. Rajshekaran Pillai, Vice Chancellor IGNOU, and the Pro Vice Chancellors, I welcome Sri A.K. Antony, Honorable Union Minister for Defence, General V.K. Singh, PVSN, AVSN, YSN, ADC, Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Mukesh Sabarwal, PVSN, AVSN Bar, VSN, Adjutant General. I also welcome special invitees, our esteemed men in uniform and other members of the audience to the inauguration of Gyandeep Centre of Excellence for the Indian Army, which aims to identify and create intellectual capital, disseminate best practices, and contribute to academic enhancement in the military environment. And before I request Dr. Lata Pillai, Pro Vice Chancellor IGNOU, to introduce the project and give out the welcome address, I would like to say a few words about Dr. Lata Pillai. Dr. Pillai is an educational administrator with nearly 3 decades experience of working in the field of higher education. Her areas of professional interest include sustainable development, promotion of women in governance and academic leadership, a strong commitment to social justice and equity in higher education has been the hallmark of Dr. Pillai's professional experience. She has also spearheaded the initiation of the first ever collaboration of an open university with the Army, Navy, and the Air Force for provision of higher education facilities for the Jawans, sailors, and airmen of the Indian Armed Forces. I call upon Dr. Lata Pillai to please move the welcome address.
On behalf of the Indira Gandhi National Open University and the Indian Army, I'd like to warmly welcome Sri A.K. Antony, Honorable Union Minister of Defence, for this inaugural function. Mr. Antony, a true statesman who has had many top positions, he is more importantly known to me personally as a role model for the transparency revolution he strongly advocates and silently practices. So we warmly welcome you in our midst here this morning. On behalf of IGNOU, I'd like to introduce Project Gyandeep, its short past and our aspirations for its glorious future. A little over 2 years ago, discussions between the Indian Army, Ministry of Defence and IGNOU commenced for articulating a framework through which the rigorous training and periods of study which its employees undertook in the Army would be assessed and certified by a university, while one-to-one collaborations between a few universities and the Indian Army were already in vogue. The leadership of both institutions, IGNOU and the Indian Army, saw the potential for professional certification and providing vertical mobility to enroll with IGNOU and obtain an academic qualification. The project was officially dedicated to the nation on November 19, 2009 by the President of India and the visitor of the university, Srimati Pratibha Devi Singh Patil. Sir, we have in our midst the Chief of the Army Staff, General V.K. Singh, a third generation officer from the Rajput Regiment who has an illustrious record in the Army. Through his inspiring leadership, we've been able to move this project ahead. Young Jawans are now provided with a meaningful post-retirement option. As on date, more than 3.5 lakh soldiers have registered with IGNOU and around 1.5 lakh have received certificates, diplomas and associate degrees. Extending the experience of persons below officer rank, the Adjutant General, Shri Mukesh Sabarwal, with his proactive leadership, proposed that IGNOU should look at the scheme being extended to its officers. The IGNOU, through a rigorous process of interaction with the faculty of the Army, visiting the infrastructure, looking at the curriculum, decided that 30% of the credits that the officers earn through their studies at the Army would be recognized for the MBA degree program. As on date, we have around 350 officers registered for the MBA in the first batch. Graduating from these experiences, the Army brought forward the proposal for the Centre of Excellence. While it is natural to opine that excellence is something to be earned and not just a nomenclature given, the purpose of calling this center so is because of its multifarious functions. The Army has been in partnership with a couple of universities doing various academic activities, and each of these have attained notable benchmarks. This center, to be inaugurated today, brings together the teaching, research, and professional development initiatives of the Army under one roof. It serves as an interface point and a nodal point for many of the activities in the education sector. It will be managed largely by the personnel of the Army within the broad framework of a university. I'd also like to take this opportunity to welcome Professor V.N. Rajshekaran Pillai, the Vice Chancellor of IGNOU. He truly epitomizes what one said, that nothing will be attempted if all possible objections must be first overcome. So his drive and leadership have made this project possible. His vision to spot opportunities and lead the institution from the front has made a great difference to many institutions which he has led over the past two decades. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all the personnel of the Indian Army, directors of schools, heads of divisions, faculty from the IGNOU, members of the press, and other well-wishers who are present here. In welcoming all present here for this inaugural function, I'd like to summarize the uniqueness of this relationship through an often quoted example in the field of management. Five frogs were sitting on a log. Four decided to jump off. How many were left? A reflex response would be one, but the correct answer is five. You may ask me why. This is because there is a difference between deciding and doing, and that's what this project has been all about.
Thank you, Dr. Pillai. Professor V.N. Rajshekaran Pillai, the Vice Chancellor of IGNOU, has been at the helm of affairs of many higher education institutions during his career.
Most respected Union Minister of Defence, Antony Sir, General V.K. Singh, Chief of Army Staff, Adjutant General Mukesh Sabarwal, distinguished officers from the Indian Army, my colleagues from the university, members from the printed and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me appreciate the efforts taken by the Indian Army for collaborating with Indira Gandhi National Open University for providing education in addition to training for the soldiers of the Indian Army and also officers at the officers level. This particular project, Gyandeep, was initiated almost 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, when Lieutenant General Kochar approached Indira Gandhi National Open University for identifying possibilities for certification of the education and training which is imparted by the various educational and training wings of Indian Army to get certification at appropriate levels. We had also effective interaction with the Adjutant General, Mukesh Sabarwal, on various occasions. Indira Gandhi National Open University welcomed this initiative and, without compromising the objectives of the Indian Army, looking at the necessities of providing education to them, looking at the necessities for creating a second life opportunities for those who are retiring from the Indian Army, we took up this particular project. And on the Silver Jubilee celebrations of Indira Gandhi National Open University, most respected Rashtrapati dedicated this particular project, Gyandeep, to the nation as one of the most socially relevant projects. Ever since the project has been introduced, it has attracted not only attention from the entire country, from the all over the world. If you just look at the literature and references to Gyandeep project all over the world from the internet, you can see hundreds of reports coming regularly. Probably one of the most socially relevant international projects in education and training jointly by a national university and the Indian Army. Now, activities are going very effectively all over the country. We looked at various options for strengthening the system. We have provided certificate diplomas and associate degrees or advanced diploma to a number of soldiers. And those who have been awarded the associate degrees, they are given now opportunities for the third year of a degree program. And it is, I don't have to mention about the importance of education and training to an audience of this kind. But I would definitely highlight the importance or the gain or the profit which the nation is going to accrue through this effective collaboration. We need 500 million youth to be trained in this country in the years to come. We need several ten thousands of colleges in this country, several thousands of universities. Only 5% of our youth has some sort of a certification. There is need for providing a certification to this youth in this country. And this youth requires skills and knowledge which are not only required for improving the quality of life of this country, this youth are going to get knowledge and skills which are necessary for the whole world, because the percentage of youth population in this country is the maximum, and therefore it is necessary that we should create enough infrastructure and enough intellectual and training capabilities for providing education and skill development to millions of youth in this country. And we would, through this Gyandeep Centre for Excellence and through this collaboration, we intend to create such facilities availing the expertise after retirement from the Indian Army to provide education. there is no dearth of resources or infrastructure in this country. What is required is a mindset to collaborate, a mindset to find out what is required and then try to do it with conviction. And this project is a clear example of this activity. Indira Gandhi National Open University, the directors of the school, the provost chancellors, the board of management, the academic council, the various school councils, all these bodies took up this project very, very proactively. And let me once again congratulate the entire team headed by Dr. Lata Pillai, provost chancellor, who is looking after this scheme almost independently to bring this particular project to this level. We are very confident that the type of advanced training which the Indian Army gets as part of the military activities, they will get additional opportunities for education. Training and education are two different things, and education is more holistic, and it is very necessary that those who are getting training should also get a holistic view of life, holistic view of the society, and that is where education is going to be important. Similarly, education without training is also incomplete. What we are doing in our education institution is definitely theoretical training, not theoretical education, and then try to provide some sort of a skills. And this project would be a leading example for the country for effective mixing of training and skills, which are very necessary for improving the quality of life and life management systems in a highly populated country like India. I take this opportunity to thank the Honorable Union Minister of Defence for accepting our invitation. Of course, he's quite aware of the significance of this project. He was looking at this project in a very, very positive way. I am extremely glad that the Honorable Union Minister of Defence is here to inaugurate this Gyandeep Centre for Excellence, which will be probably the most socially relevant project in the whole world, sir. You would be proud to see that this is really happening in this country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Pillai. Our next speaker, Lieutenant General Mukesh Sabarwal, commissioned into the 9th Battalion of the Rajput Regiment on 13th June 1971.
Thank you, please. Okay, we will start. Thank you. Honorable Raksha Mantri, Shri A.K. Antony, Chief of the Army Staff, General V.K. Singh, Vice Chancellor, Indira Gandhi National Open University, Professor Rajashekaran Pillai, Pro Vice Chancellors, Faculty and Management of IGNOU, Senior Officers, JCOs and Jawans of the Indian Army, Media, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen. It is indeed a proud privilege for me to be here on this occasion of the inauguration of the Centre of Excellence, which is a landmark event in Project Gyandeep. They say there is nothing in a caterpillar which indicates that it is going to become a butterfly. And similarly, we really never thought how quickly this Project Gyandeep would become such a promising and a very recognizable project in such a short time. We are all aware that in the army, our jawans especially, they retire very young. And this has been one of the things which the government and the army and the defense forces, in fact, have been looking at very, very seriously. They need a second career when they retire, roughly at the age of around 40 when they retire. When they go out for a job, the first thing is the people want a certification of what have they done as educational qualification. And that was what set us going on this path. And sure enough, IGNOU came forward with the initiative and the dynamism of Professor Pillay. We had a collaboration. We got to set the ball rolling with General Kochhar and them meeting, and thereafter there was no looking back. We signed this MOU just about 2 years back, in fact in September 2009, and today we have reached a stage, like Professor Lata Pillay had mentioned, over 3.5 lakh registrants. But that is not the only path. We have to go and strive further ahead. Registering is one, but actually ensuring that all of them get to the level of the degree, that is a commitment which we owe to our troops, and we in the Army, under the guidance and leadership of General V.K. Singh, who, for whom this is a part of his overall vision, that we must empower our soldier. We must give him the wherewithal, what we can. And this is a project by which we can do it. The first part, that is certification. And thereafter, we are looking at enhancing their skills so that they are ready to get into a job. And for this, there are other projects which the RRM and the Ministry of Defence is looking at very seriously, so that we can have vocational training centres thereafter for the people to get jobs with the industry and in other areas. So when we look at this, to us, education is really extremely important. Education of not only the officer, but the JCO and the Jawan, more importantly. Like sculpture is to a block of marble, education is to the human soul. That's what the saying goes. And to us, we also look at it with as much reverence as the saying has rightly said. Hereafter, we pledge ourselves that with the Center of Excellence, with the idea which we have, the Chief has mentioned, the other universities, other educational institutions will get part of this entire thing, get roped into a network, and it is our endeavor to see that not only these 12 lakh odd Jawans of the Indian Army, but their wards and their extended families also get into this entire program, and all of us together with the partnership of Indira Gandhi National Open University, we look for a great future ahead. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, General Sabarwal. Our next address is by General V.K. Singh, Chief of Army Staff. General Vijay Kumar Singh is a third generation officer of the Rajput Regiment.
That's okay.
Okay.
Honorable Raksha Mantri Shri A.K. Antony Ji, Professor Rajshekharan Pillay, Vice Chancellor, the Pro Vice Chancellor, members of the faculty from IGNOU, senior officers in uniform, our JCOs and Jawans who are present here, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. It is a privilege to see our idea growing so well. And our aim was twofold. One, to empower our JCOs and Jawans who do get a great amount of education and military training, but that needs to be recognized and certified. And the second was to ensure a greater capacity building for our officers. And towards that end, the zeal with which IGNOU came to implement these is really laudable. And I must compliment both the Vice Chancellor and the Pro Vice Chancellor and the faculty, which went out of its way to ensure that our ideas got converted into reality. Let's give them a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. They have really helped the Indian Army in realizing our dream of ensuring that our men get empowered, and it becomes possible for them then to get picked up for the second career because they all retire so young. At the same time, we were looking at capacity building for our officers, and with IGNOU's help, we have been able to start the management program that starts now with almost 300 officers who are enrolled. We have also gone ahead in signing MOUs with certain universities, and certain more are coming forward, which will allow our officers to get for themselves higher education, which will not only assist the army but will also assist them in ensuring that they are recognized much better when they go out of uniform. This particular project has really seen a great amount of enthusiasm from our men. The only thing probably still lacking, which we are looking forward to, is that greater number get their associate degrees in the days to come. Although the large number of enrollment has taken place, but we are still slightly short on the numbers that probably we wished who would have got their associate degrees. And I'm quite sure our men will work hard to do this, along with our officers, who will motivate them to get into this particular scheme. The IGNOU has provided us great benefit, and the center of excellence that we are starting today will allow us to network with more and more people who want to partner with the Indian Army in meeting our twin demands for our people, that is the empowerment of our men and capacity building, so that we can not only make our army much more academically better but much more capable of meeting the future challenges. I would once again like to thank the Vice Chancellor and Pro-Vice Chancellor and the members of the faculty of IGNOU for assisting us in this project, and also all our officers and men who have come forward to make use of these opportunities. The Raksha Mantri has supported this project of ours thoroughly, and I'm quite sure that the type of support that he has provided to us will go a long way in the army meeting its vision in this particular field. Thank you very much.
Thank you, General V.K. Singh. I would now like to request Professor V.N. Rajshekaran Pillai to felicitate our guests of honor by presenting mementos to mark this occasion. Shri A.K. Antony, Honorable Union Minister for Defense. General V.K. Singh, Chief of the Army Staff. Lieutenant General Mukesh Sabharwal, Adjutant General. I would now like to urge upon Professor Pillai to present the brochure to Sri A.K. Antony and mark its official release. Last but not the least, Professor Pillai, to please assist the Raksha Mantri for the official inauguration of the website of the Centre of Excellence, the GCE website. Thank you. Thank you, Shri Antony. Shri A.K. Antony, Honorable Union Minister for Defence, a former Chief Minister of Kerala, and he happened to be the youngest Chief Minister of the state. Shri Antony, to please address the gathering.
Chief of the Army Staff, General V.K. Singh. Vice Chancellor, Professor V.N. Rajshekhar Pillai, Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Lida Pillai, Adjutant General, Lieutenant General Mukesh Sabarwal, Senior Officers from the Armed Forces, Dear Jawans, Distinguished Friends from the Indira Gandhi National University, friends from the media. We have summoned here today to start a journey that will last a lifetime and in the process change several lives. Already, Vice Chancellor, Army Chief and AGS explained the importance of this program. At the outset, I have to thank and congratulate Professor Pillai and Chief of Army Staff, General V.K. Singh, for coming together to take this initiative. The involvement of soldiers is an important issue that must be addressed and monitored at all levels on a regular basis. In today's world of information technology, the need for 3 E's, educating, enabling, and empowering the fraternity of service personnel can never be overemphasized. Gone are the days when empowerment of a soldier, be it from the point of view of education, or that of better career prospects, was unheard of. Today, soldiers are well educated and technology savvy. The effort at the empowerment of our soldiers will really go a long way in improving the gross enrollment ratio in our country. This initiative will further enhance the professional competence of our serving soldiers. You also provide them second career alternatives once they retire. The empowerment projects launched by the Army are popular and come as a confirmation they are a step in the right direction. Such empowerment initiatives, however, need to be sustained on a long-term basis to have lasting results. That is what the AG emphasized. Our government has taken several initiatives and aimed at empowering the soldiers. Resettlement courses, effective placement sales, and strong tie-ups with various industries and other organizations to utilize the vast experience of the retiring Army personnel to name a few. However, setting in place an institutionalized mechanism to impart training in certain skills before these personnel retire, I am sure will address the challenge to a very large extent. However, there are certain other issues involved, like creation of the infrastructure backed by credible certification mechanisms. Vocational training centers could be established alongside regimental training centers, other selected defense establishments to provide the required training. These training centers could then also help the personnel in finding suitable jobs. We need to keep a futuristic vision and a focused approach to utilize this trained, disciplined and committed workforce. Today, soldiers' empowerment will turn a new page as a result of the collaborative initiatives between the Indian Army and Indira Gandhi National Open University, Gyandeep that has resulted in setting up a center of excellence. The global security environment continues to be a cause of concern. The situation in our neighborhood poses various challenges. There is thus a pressing need to strengthen the internal fabric of our society and nation to generate more strength to meet such challenges. Our armed forces have given a good account of themselves during external aggression or internal strife. These veterans must be integrated in the society, as they would no doubt continue to work with the same dedication and commitment that they displayed as members of the armed forces. It goes without saying that a center of excellence with academia is an appropriate requirement to enhance all-round development of our soldiers. There could not have been a better partner than Indira Gandhi National Open University, which has a sound knowledge bank and a world-class faculty with international exposure. I am sure that the Center of Excellence will spark other centers of excellence and will come out with solutions to several outstanding issues. With these words, I am pleased to inaugurate this Center of Excellence. May the center work in consonance with the national aim of providing education to every citizen. Education alone has the potential to enable various government initiatives to meet the desired objectives. I extend my best wishes to the center for a bright and a fulfilling journey ahead. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Honorable Minister Sri A.K. Antony. I now call upon Sri U.S. Tholia, Registrar IGNOU, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Honorable Raksha Mantri, dignitaries on the dais, Pro Vice Chancellors, Member Board of Management, other senior functionaries from IGNOU and Indian Army, honored guests, special invitees, friends from media and print and electronic media. It started in 2009 with an MOU between Indira Gandhi National Open to deliver one of the most ambitious educational initiative would not have been possible without the imaginative leadership provided by the Honorable Raksha Mantri Ji, Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor B. R. Shekran Pillai and Chief of the Army Staff Sri V. K. Singh, and without the intellectual inputs and dedicated hard work of the many from IGNOU, Ministry of Defence, Indian Army and the other services. On behalf of IGNOU, I and the entire fraternity of the higher education, I express my gratitude to Honourable Union Minister of Defence, Government of India, Sri A.K. Antony, for his encouragement to the project and having spared his precious time to inaugurate the Gyandeep Centre of Excellence. The Chief of Army Staff, General V.K. Singh, has been a great supporter of the Gyandeep Project, and his encouragement has been invaluable to the success of the project. I thank Chief of the Army Staff, General V.K. Singh, for being here to grace the occasion, and look forward to continued support and encouragement to the initiative. I am also grateful to all the members of the Board of Management, Indira Gandhi National Open University, who very positively felicitated the launch of this project, as well as for their continued support and guidance. I am also grateful to Honorable Vice Chancellor, Sri Rajshekhar Pillai Ji, for his initiative and leadership in conceptualizing and bringing the project into fruition, and look forward for his continued guidance and support. My gratitude to Lieutenant General Mukesh Agarwal, whose active inputs at various stages has helped the project immensely. I also thank Dr. Lata Pillai, Pro Vice Chancellor IGNOU, and Lieutenant General Kocher, who have been involved in this project from the initial stages. Their constant guidance, hard work has brought the project the success, and we look forward to their continued guidance. I express my gratitude to honored guests and special invitees, and especially friends from the electronic and print media for making themselves available to be present on this occasion. I thank you one and all present here from IGNOU and the Indian Army and all others who have found time to be part of this occasion. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Shritolia. Ladies and gentlemen, we have reached the end of our session for the day. May I request everybody present to please join us for tea outside in the lobby. Thank you.
Minister of Vehicle. Pardon? Yes, the Minister of Vehicle can keep it to the American. Thank you.
Yeah, economic. Robert? Yeah.